There are several ways to have the function keys affect a screen change. The first is to use a screen change push button, and then simply specify which function key will take you to which screen. See the video on the screen change object for more on that. The second option is to use a screen selector object. That one actually puts a menu of screens up on the screen for the user to select from. Again, there's a whole video on how to use that object, so check that out for more information on him. In this video, we're going to use the function object. Each function key is assigned to go to a different screen. You can use either the soft keys here by pressing a touch screen, or you can use the actual function keys. Let's see how to set that up. In this project, we have 5 screens, each with their own color, and a 6th screen that we're going to use for the background. We're going to put the function object on this screen and then let all of the other screens use that as a background screen. This way, we can set up the function keys in one place and only have to maintain them in one place in the project. Check out the video on setting up background screens to learn more about how to do that. So for this video, we're just going to double-click or drag the function object onto the screen. When that dialog comes up, we can see all 10 function keys. For each one, we can specify which screen it should jump to. Let's assign F1 through F5 to change from screens 1 through 5. So we're going to make this a screen change to screen 1, a screen change to screen 2, screen change to screen 3, a screen change to screen 4, and finally a screen change to screen 5. If everything looks good, then we just hit OK. In order to use this function object on all the other screens, we have to tell them to take advantage of that. So we go to screen 1 and say we want to use a background screen, and we want to use this screen 6 as the background screen. Same thing for screen 2. Same thing for screen 3. Don't forget to enable it. Screen 4, and enable it. And finally, screen 5. Now, all of these screens, you can see the background screen is a little dimmer than the rest of the objects on the screen to remind you it is a background screen. But again, the beauty of this is now all these screens can take advantage of the one background object. Let's simulate that and see how it works. So let's see, F2 should take us to screen 2, F3 to screen 3, F4 to screen 4, and F5 to screen 5. What if we don't want these labels on the screen? Can we get rid of those? Sure. Let's go back to the object. Now remember, you can't edit the object on any screen. You have to be on the background screen to edit the object. To get rid of those labels, we just turn off show keys. Now when we simulate the project, or bring it up on a real panel, the labels are gone. But the function keys still operate as expected. If you want a real good example of how to do screen changes using a navigation menu, check out the how-to video demo of the bottling plant for an example of how to do screen changes with a graphical menu on the screen. That's all there is to using function keys for screen changes. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.